As you build your course in Sakai, it's important to make sure your content is clear and easy for students to navigate. A great way to keep things organized is by using Sakai's Lessons tool to structure your course content into weekly subpages. Subpages provide space where you can design your lessons and share all kinds of content with students, including documents, web links, and links to content in other Sakai tools, such as assignments, tests and quizzes, and discussion forums. In this video, we'll build a new subpage to show you how to incorporate each of these elements. Here's a site that I'm building for an online computer course. In the Lessons area, I've already added content for Weeks 1 and 2, so let's add a subpage for Week 3. I'll click the Add Content button and select Add Subpage. In the Page Title field, I'll give this subpage a name that's related to the content it'll contain. For example, I'll call this one Week 3 Searching the Web. Then we'll click Create. Sakai automatically takes us to the new subpage, but we can see where it's been added by clicking Lessons in the navigation bar at the top of the page. This takes us back to the main Lessons area, and here, under Week 2, is our new Week 3 subpage. To help clarify when Week 3 starts and ends, I'll click its Edit button and type the date range in the item description box, and then click Update Item. Okay, we're ready to add some content to the subpage. Click Week 3 to open it back up. From here, we'll be working with the Add Content button, which allows you to add a wide variety of content, including text, links to documents, presentations and websites, and links to activities and other Sakai tools. We'll begin by specifying when this week's assignments are due. It's possible to have multiple due dates for the week's assignments, but if you teach online, it's less confusing for students if there's just one due date for the week, such as Thursday at 11 p.m. This allows online students to know when things are due and establish their weekly schedules. We'll click the Add Content button and then Add Text. I'll type this week's due date, and to make it stand out, I'll make the text a little larger and apply bold formatting. Click Save, and the due date appears on the subpage. Next, I'll add this week's learning objective. Click Add Content, and then Add Text. I'll type a heading, for example, Learning Objective for the Week, to introduce the objective, and then I'll type the objective. This example has only one, but your subpage might have more. Then to create page structure for students who might use assistive technology, I'll format the heading as a Heading 2 by highlighting it and selecting Heading 2 from the Paragraph Format drop-down menu. There we go, and then click Save. Our objective appears on the subpage. Alternatively, you can provide an overview to explain to students the importance of the week's material. I'll click the Edit button to add my overview below the objective. Next, I'll post the reading assignment for the week. I could continue to click the Add Content button, but instead I'll click the Add New Item button. It looks like a plus sign. And then I'll select Add Text. I'll type and format some of the text, and just as I did for the learning objective heading earlier, I'll make sure to format this heading as a heading too. If you have a document to share with students, you can make it easy for students to view the file by uploading and creating a link to it. I have a PDF of an article I'd like to add here under the Reading section on our subpage. I'll click the bottommost Add New Item button and select Add Content Links. In the Item Name field, I'll type a descriptive name for the file and indicate that this is a PDF. Then we'll click the Choose Files button to locate the file, and save. Sakai saves a copy of the file to the site's resources area, and a link to the file appears on the subpage. If you'd like to add a descriptive note about the file, click the Links Edit button and type a description in the item description box and click Update Item. You can also use the Add Content Links option to link to a website. I've already copied the address of an online article related to this week's content, so I'll provide the title of the article in the item name field, paste the address here in the add URL field, and click save. As I did earlier, I'll add a descriptive note by clicking the edit button. Alright, our subpage is starting to take shape. Let's take a look at how to add tool links. Tool links make it easy for students to go directly to an activity that's been created with another Sakai tool, such as a forum discussion, a quiz, or an assignment. In this site, I've already created a week 3 quiz and published it. To add a link to the quiz from our subpage, I'll click the Add New Item button and Link to a Test or Quiz. I'll select the quiz I want and click Use Selected Item. A link to the quiz appears on the subpage. It will take students directly to the week 3 quiz, so they won't need to hunt around for it elsewhere in the site. I can click the quiz's edit button to add a note or description. In a similar way, if I've created an assignment in Sakai, for example, a paper students will need to turn in, I can link to it by clicking the Add New Item button and selecting Link to an Assignment. A list of assignments I've created appears. I'll select the one for this week and click Use Selected Item. As with other items I've placed on the subpage, I'll add a description for this assignment by clicking the Edit button. If you've created a discussion topic in forums, you can link directly to it as well by clicking the Add New Item button and selecting Link to a Forum or Topic. Select the topic to link to and click Use Selected Item. And again, I can add a note. This weekly subpage looks like it's complete. Let's take a look at how it appears in Student View. It looks good. The subpage contains everything students need for the entire week, laid out clearly, and all in one place. It should be easy for students to figure out what they'll need to do. Alright, I think you're ready to use the Lessons tool to build a subpage of your own. If you're teaching an online or hybrid course, we strongly recommend using the Lessons tool to organize your weekly content. And if you're teaching face-to-face courses, we think you'll find this tool to be very useful as well. If you need assistance with the Lessons tool, please contact Sakai Help at durhamtech.edu.